Breaking news, guys. Now, I have this breaking news idea of what NRS will possibly be doing with Sonya Blade. Now, a lot of you have been asking, where's Sonya? Where's Sonya? Where's Sonya? I told you guys in a previous video that my highest prediction is that Sonya is being held back because she is a main part of the story. She is a massive part of the story. So they don't want to reveal her just yet. I also said in that theory that she was going to be played by Kerry Hoskins by the time they do reveal the actual Sonya for this game. Now, Mortal Kombat without Sonya, it just does not seem right, so I don't believe for a second that we ain't gonna get Kano and that we ain't gonna get Sonya Blade. So let's go ahead and talk about this video here. I just wanted to acknowledge the previous videos to kind of keep you guys calm, to let you know we will be getting Sonya at some point. But this video here is gonna make you scratch your head. You'll probably unsubscribe from the channel, which is understandable because what I'm about to say is so dark, I don't think you can handle it. So let's get into it. So basically, what I think NRS is doing here with this new universe is that they're going to be telling a completely different story with Sonya involved. Now, for those of you that don't know, there was a very, very old Mortal Kombat series. It was a comic book. It was through Malibu Comics, which I will be debuting on the channel in shortly just a few days. So in that comic book, Shao Kahn ends up marrying Sonya Blade. He marries Sonya. I think she's held like she gets kidnapped or something like that. And he marries her because he wants to, I think, like merge Outworld with Earthrealm, and marrying Sonya makes it weaker or something like that. We're going to find out just how it's going to play out over a period of time. But so far, it seems they're heading that way because I've been reading that comic book very closely. And the things that we've gotten already in MK1 is Shao Kahn with his eyes turning red, and then Shao Kahn being able to have dark powers, which hasn't been revealed yet, but it will be revealed. So I have a video with a crap ton of evidence proving that they're going to be using certain story modes, I mean, certain storylines from the comics in Mortal Kombat 1, which is extremely, extremely dope. So I want you to stay tuned to the channel because we will be doing some comic book readings, and we're going to do those comic book reading live. So that's something we're probably going to do on Tuesday. So Tuesday is basically going to be live day, is what it is, because we'll be doing gameplay live on Tuesdays, and we'll have some, of course, some live streams on Tuesdays, and we'll make sure that we get into the comics so we can kind of read them all together. That's what's going to happen. So get ready because a lot of changes is coming to the channel. But as again, I truly think that they're going to have Sonya Blade married to Shao Kahn. Now, Sonya Blade also has a brother. His name is Daniel Blade. So we're going to wonder, are we getting a new Blade character? That's going to be another question that we need to answer. Also, I'll probably make a separate video on that. But NRS is doing a fantastic job at this point on what they're doing. So I wanted to show the Sonya fans some love to let you guys know Ed Boon is not stupid. He's not stupid at all. He is going to put Sonya in the game. But I will tell you this much. They are going to allow the game to run for as long as it possibly can. Once they do that, they're going to hit the refresh button and they're going to give you the characters that you're asking for. We're going to get the majority of these characters in an Aftermath DLC pack. So if you don't see Sonya within Combat 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, or Combat Pack 6, then you're going to be able to see Sonya in the Aftermath DLC. Now, mind you, the combat packs that we are going to be getting are going to have characters. So far, more than likely, it's going to be 3. That's my educated guess. However, there will be special occasions. For example, the Aftermath pack will have characters a part of it or whatever. So you can count that as 4. And then there may be 2 other things that we'll probably get later down the line. But I know for a fact we'll be getting like some holiday skins and stuff like that, which would be super dope. Now, mind you, I have no verified information or nothing. This is all purely educated guesses. And I just wanted to take the time out to, you know, give you guys this breaking news of this idea that I have, where I think they're going to take this story in the direction of Shao Kahn beefing with Sindel, and then they're going to take the direction of Sonya being married to Shao Kahn. Or I should say General Shao, because you guys hate when I say Shao Kahn for some reason, even though he turns into Shao Kahn. But anyway, that's all I really have for you guys. I truly appreciate you tuning into the video and watching the video. I want to pass this question off to you guys in the comment section below. How do you feel about them possibly using the story mode of Sonya being married to Shao Kahn to weaken Earthrealm's forces to be able to merge the realms? That is the reason he would marry Sonya. And of course, Sonya is not on board with it. This is all against her will. So do you think they will actually go dark like that and do something like that? I know a lot of you don't like that story mode and it doesn't sound appealing. And I'll be honest with you, it don't. But it would make for some really good story mode because, mind you, how else would you get story mode popping? Piss off the fans. You gotta piss off the fans. That'll get everybody talking. Now, I told you guys 2 years ago that freaking Chronisha, aka Chronicle, the Keeper of Time, was going to be returning. And a lot of you said I was wrong. Well, my highly educated guest documentary, it was 100% true. So make sure you tune in tonight at 11:45 p.m. as we have a Chronisha celebration party. It's called the Sly for Chronica party. That's what it's going to be called as we get our revenge on Liu Kang. So tune in tonight because I will be breaking down Chronica in story mode. She has been confirmed to be in story mode so far from what everybody is speculating. Let me correct myself. Everybody, including myself, is speculating that Chronica has returned based on a story mode clip that has been released due to early access from Warner Brothers. Now, the character has baby blue eyes and speak just like Chronica, so that's why we're assuming that it's Chronica. No employee has confirmed that this is Chronica at all. Nobody confirmed it. It's what we're all assuming, but I'm gonna go ahead and tell you it's definitely Chronica, guys. Personal opinion. She got the baby blue eyes, she got the alopecia bald head going on, she got the robe going on, and she got that long voice that she be using. So tune in tonight because we are going to be having a 1 hour and 20 minute hangout. So get your popcorn, get your juice, your chips, everything. We just going to kind of be kicking it tonight is what we're going to be doing. So hopefully you guys are interested in that and you all want to tune in for it. So I'm going to be doing something super special for you guys. Again, thank you so much for tuning into the channel. More content is set to come. I'm also going to be introducing some other games back to the channel too. We'll probably start dropping those on the weekend, and it's time to turn up the heat. We got to turn up the content, baby. So you know what I'm saying? But anyway, guys, thank you so much for tuning in. Catch you in the next one. Be sure to answer that question below, and remember, if you're new to the channel, make sure you watching that video, make sure you smash that subscribe button and turn on post notifications. Yes, this is your brand new favorite and exclusive place for daily Mortal Kombat content. With that being said, thank you so much and catch you in the next one. We out.